Okay. Whew. Hey, Teresa. Oh my goodness, it's hot up in here, y'all. Hey, Paya. So I am doing a tutorial DIY for my balloon arches, your favorite balloon girl. All right, so it's a little hot in here. Hot in my room, so I'm trying to fan on that I can't turn on. So one thing that I wanted to go over before I start is actually the machine that I'm actually gonna be using. Hey, girl. All right. All right, so this right here, hey girl, is a balloon machine that you can buy literally off of Amazon, and it's 20 bucks. I purchased my balloon machine like in 2012, 2013 when I was first getting started, and this is actually $100. But if you purchase this one, it's like $20. It does the same thing. The only thing is I have two nozzles. That works. You literally just press down on it and the air comes out. You can turn it on and off. But let me turn it off so it doesn't do that again. But if you press down on it, the air comes out. But it gives me two nozzles on here, and that's the reason why this was $99. But this one only has one nozzle, and it's here that you press down on, but the air automatically comes out of this one. 20 bucks. If you're not trying to do this like the way that I am professionally, if you just want to do it for a kid's party, get this off of Amazon. Once I complete this live, everything is going to be in the comments, so you guys can see, so you can DIY on your own. If you don't want to hire me, if you want to hire me, you know that I am for hire, and that's my phone number. It'll also be in the comments. All right, so these little things right here are called what we call a pair of two balloons. What I did was I tied two of them together. So I am gonna blow two balloons up so you guys can see me, if this allows me to bend down. Yes, it does. If y'all ever see my toes, they are not painted. So don't be trying to, like, you know, put me on blast. All right. So you take two balloons. Y'all can see that, right? And I'm literally just going to blow them up at the same time. Taking two balloons. And you place each of them on the nozzle. Something's wrong with this balloon. All right, just place two of them on the nozzle, and you're just going to blow them up at the same time. And these are, let me let this out. And these are air-filled balloons, all right? So now I have two balloons, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie these two balloons together to make a pair like that. So literally, instead of tying them each individually, you can do that if that's easier for you, but I suggest that you tie them together. You just seriously just tie them together like this, like you're tying something together, like shoestrings or whatever. And you just tie it in a knot, and then bam, they're stuck together. They can't come apart. Now, the next step, I mean, you continue to do that. Clearly, I have a lot of balloons here, so I'm not going to continue to do that. The other thing that you want to purchase, you can absolutely go buy yourself a column. Hold on. Okay, so you can go buy yourself a column, or you can be like me that repurposes things. So y'all know those little lights? You know those little lights? Let me show you, because I literally have a light like right behind me. Hold on. Light right there. You see that? That little light right there. That little light that you get from Walmart. You guys can purchase that. And, hold on, I gotta put my charger back on. When you purchase that from Walmart, it's like 7 to 10 bucks sometimes. You literally just take the top part of the light off, and it's gonna look like this. I like to put like a balloon at the top because that's where the top of my towers are gonna go, and with the balloons, and I don't want the top of it to be so sharp that it pokes my balloon, you see? All right, so when you get your Walmart lamp, you literally just put it together like this, and you repurpose it, and that's how you can use it as a tower. Okay? All right, so. Hey, Sheila girl. All right, so also at the very bottom, because I like to cover it with, literally this is a table, the plastic tablecloths that you get from the Dollar Tree. I usually like to do black or white at the bottom. That way, so it's covered perfectly. Hey, Joanna girl. All right, so what we're doing is, just to catch everybody up, because she just said, what we doing? I'm showing you guys how to do a balloon tower, because I told my cousin one time, I'm going to be real, I was like, I can't afford to hire me. The way that my salary is set up and the way that my balloon prices are set up, I have to be able to make a profit, so I can't just be gifting it all the time. So I want to show DIYs for the people that have a budget where it doesn't allow them to purchase these, you know, balloons. You can do it yourself. That's the purpose of my YouTube video, which will also be in the comments once I finish this live. Okay, you guys? So, all right. So now you've placed together your balloon tower base, which is your lamp stand from Walmart, which is probably about $7 to $10. And you're going to take two of the balloons. So remember, we already learned how to make these, and you're literally just going to take two balloons, kind of make sure they're the same size. Usually I have a sizer, but I'm kind of like in a rush for these, so I didn't size these balloons. Yes, girl, Joanna, you have plenty of time left. I'm so good, Sam. Thank you for asking. All right, so you just take these two balloons. Let me come back a little bit. And you're literally going to cross them like this. You see how I'm crossing them? Right? So you take them, you cross them, and you're going to twist it around so it locks together. When I say twist it around, you're literally just going to twist all the balloons around. Doesn't matter how many times. It needs to be at least two times. Two times. So now, all four balloons are secured together. Doesn't matter where I pull, they're secured together. They're locked in. Now, depending on your pattern, most people actually like the pattern where it goes the spiral pattern. So that means that you're going to have two of each color, three of each color, however your spiral is. But basically, you want to have for this case, we're going to say it's a black and yellow spiral. So you're going to have black, yellow, black, yellow. If you want it to be two colors on one side, then that'll be black on one side, yellow on one side, and then you'll continue on. I'm going to show you how to make the spiral pattern in just a moment. So we're going to take these balloons, and you're literally going to start at the bottom of your base, and you're literally just going to slide it in there. Now, to secure it, because this can fall off, right? You want to twist it. Once you go in like that, you want to actually twist it and twist it around. So I'm doing this with one hand, so it's better to have two hands. And bam, now this can't come off. It's secure. But then also, remember, you said you want to make the spiral pattern, so you just make sure that you twist it in a way that where it goes black, yellow, bumblebees. All right, y'all got that? What's up, Carl? What's up? That's my dad's best friend, y'all. Hey. All right, your next set of balloons is gonna be here. And you just, remember what I said? You just twist them like that, right? Black, yellow. I'm going to do it again. You take your black, yellow, twist it, and go like that. All right. So now I'm going to take this. And remember, we want the spiral, so it's still going to go the same way. When you go inside, you just push it inside. And actually, if I start like this, it'll be better. So you push it inside, and you literally just twist. Since these balloons are open, you want to cross these balloons so they're secure on the pole. Cross it. All right, so you see how it's already starting to spiral? You want to make sure that it's going where it's going black, and all the way up. Because if you do like this, actually, that doesn't make sense right now because it's going to continue to do the same thing. But you continue to go up, right? You take this, twist them around, and then you twist them. Push it down, Now this is where you can see. See, it's not doing that spiral thing that I like. So you want to make sure that you twist it in a way where you have a pattern. Yellow, 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 black, 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 right? Perfect. All right. We're gonna take these and you're gonna go on and go on. See? Not so hard, right? It just looks hard. And I've been doing this since 2012, so if you're not doing it, hey Andrea, if you're not doing it so as fast as me, just know that I've been doing it since 2012. And you just keep on going. All right. Look at that. Spiral, spiral, spiral. So usually what people do is they get like a big balloon at top and then they just place it like on top of the balloon, or they put those big numbers. Maybe you're turning 30, 21, however. What's up, Sandra? And you just put it at the top and that's how it's going to go. You usually only need, if you blow these balloons up right. If you blow the balloons up right, you usually only need 36 on each tower. And this tower is about, I'm 5'6", so it's about 5 feet. I don't really measure them. I just kind of like eyeball it. So, and then you would just put the big topper balloon right there. Any questions, you guys? I'm going to have a YouTube channel. I already have a YouTube channel, actually. So make sure that you guys subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you, girl. And you'll be able to get more tips from me when it comes to your balloon decor. However, if you don't want to do your balloon decor, remember you can hire your favorite balloon girl. Like, my shirts are so cute, y'all. Like, I was so excited when I got this shirt made at the swap shop. And then there's my little phone number. People be thinking it's a wrong phone number. I'm like, no, I'm from Texas, and I'm not giving up my Texas phone number. You know, you got to let the people know. I live in South Florida, but I'm from Texas. Hey, Melissa! All right, so any questions? None? Because your girl got to get back to work because I took a break. And y'all will see my decor probably for this later. I may post it. I may not, where you'll see the big balloon at the top. But thank you guys so much for tuning in, and this is over because I work from home and I gotta get back to work. Bye. Working it up from a point of dancing in the rain like it's tango. Keep life is hard, just looked at the gun. Now you know why I shot it like fuego. Bing.